Welcome to the Daktronics Introduction to DMP-8000. This video will give a brief summary of the features of the DMP-8000 player and VNet software. Follow along on screen or on your own DMP-8000 computer as we explore the program. When you start the machine, the VNet software should launch automatically. The program might not be visible on the desktop, but an icon in the taskbar will be visible when it's running. This is because in some systems, the display acts as a second monitor on the computer and therefore will show a mouse cursor or anything dragged off the main screen onto the display. If version 5 of the VNet software does not show up in the taskbar, it can be found in the Start menu under Programs, Daktronics, VNet 4, VNet. For version 6, go to the Start menu, All Programs, Daktronics, DMP-8000 folder, DMP-8000. Open the VNet control panel by right-clicking the icon in the taskbar and choosing Control Panel. The icon will look similar to one of these images depending on the software version. For all versions of the DMP-8000 software, the control panel defaults to the Overview tab. From here, you can see a screenshot of the content playing on the DMP-8000 player, which refreshes every second. Below this is the display size and frame rate that the player is set to. If the DMP-8000 player is not the primary player, the display might be set to 720 by 1280, 1080 by 1920, or another standard video size. If the DMP-8000 player is the primary player on your system, this will most likely be set to the size of the actual display. The display size and frame rate is predetermined by a Daktronics technician or trainer and should not be modified. For version 6 of DMP-8000, these settings are located in the configuration webpage. To access the configuration webpage, open Internet Explorer and type the IP address of your DMP-8000 computer. Login credentials are required. Once logged in, you'll be taken to the display tab with a monitor window. Here you can monitor the output of the DMP-8000 player. The Tools tab contains the basic configuration information, such as display size, version information, and IP address. There's also an option to restart the player by clicking Reset Display. The Configuration or Advanced tabs should only be used by a Daktronics technician or trainer, and if modified incorrectly, can cause system errors. For version 5 and below, the Configuration Settings tab shows some of the same information visible on the Overview tab, along with other important information, including the computer name and the VNet software version. Next is the Edit Configuration tab. These settings should only be used by a Daktronics technician or trainer, and if modified incorrectly, can damage the player and cause it to stop working. The last tab shows error logs. This is used by a technician or a trainer for diagnostics on the player. On the top right side of the control panel are a series of four buttons: Automatic Scheduling, Play Test Pattern, Restart Player, and Clear Player's Playlist. Automatic Scheduling and Clear Player's Playlist should only be pressed if instructed to do so by a Daktronics technician or trainer. The Play Test Pattern button is for diagnostics, and if used, the player will need to be restarted before playing out content. In version 6, a drop-down tab is available to select a test pattern. Select a pattern from the list and click Start Test Pattern. Click Stop Test Pattern to resume normal operation. If the DMP-8000 player is ever frozen or not working, you may need to press the Restart Player button. This can take up to 30 seconds to complete. While restarting, a message will appear on the screenshot reading, "Failed to receive an image from player." This is normal and will go away once the player has restarted. Below the buttons, the player lists the name of the file that is currently playing. This can be the name of a graphic, or a video, or a .layout file. Below this are buttons to browse for and play files. Users should not be playing content from this location. Instead, buttons are made to play out content using Display Studio on the Show Control computer. This concludes the introduction to DMP-8000 and VNet software. Continue to the next video for more information.